First language is French, so generally I didn't contribute in French. So, in order to give you that overview, I would like to make a short history, about what we do. And after that, tell about the organizations involved in Wikimedia Foundation. Because in Côte d'Ivoire, we have a local chapter, but apart from this chapter, there are other organizations that get involved in contribute to Wikimedia Foundation project. And of course, after this, talk about challenges and successes. So, I can say that maybe all started in 2008, when we first started to contribute to Wikipedia, actively, mainly on Wikipedia, creating articles about Cote d'Ivoire and culture. And we had many others occasion to teach people, organize training sessions during 2009-2012. And so on, some local activities were initiated. Like in 2012, we had the Creative Commons organization that started, and some members started to see what is Wikipedia, what is Creative Commons. And ever since 2013, we set up a local chapter. Just like I said, it's still in creation, but we started a local chapter to try to gather all these actions that are done in different Wikimedia projects. And since 2013, that local chapter has started to move to organize our training sessions, to train its members, to get them familiar with the different tools of Wikimedia. Just like I said before, concerning Wikimedia projects, it's not only the local chapter of Wikimedia that is involved, but different other activities and organizations do make action towards Wikimedia projects. We have the Mozilla Foundation. He's from the Mozilla Foundation. We have the Creative Commons community. We also have the Commercial Text Wiki project, who does actions and also this Wikimedia project. And we have the local chapter, which I talked about, which holds meeting, monthly meeting, and organize the training sessions. Concerning the challenges, I wanted to split it into two parts, talk about some few difficulties, and after this talk about the goals that we are aiming. About difficulties, the first part is that everyone's not really familiar with all Wikimedia environment and tools, etc. There's also the language. After that, those involved in the Wikimedia project are not actively involved. So, for example, we have a lot of members in the Wikimedia Foundation group, but those who actively contribute are here. The goals. We want to achieve something. We want to get more contributors. Active contribution, not only the number, but people who have contributed actively and effectively. So. And since I thought that not so many people know about the Wikimedia projects and Wikimedia tools, we would like to get more people familiar with this. This is one of the goals we are aiming. Concerning the success, now we have one Wikipedia community. This comes from the Commercial Text Wiki project. The project initiated this year, and which goal is to create high quality content about Cote d'Ivoire. So one guy Donc, if you know him, c'est Bobo. He's our Wikimedia community. We have, like I said, 5 communities actively acting in the Wikimedia movement. And we have one local chapter. We started year by year, but we're doing other things. So, also the local chapter, since 2014, we have a monthly, we organize training sessions. And since we're in the process of creating the officially created chapter, we have set on the organization and we have set some strategy until we finally are official. We have set a strategy, some goals and objectives to reach. So monthly we have activities, sometimes strategy activities, sometimes training sessions. And we, to be more effective, we have built a website, a wiki, where we train, we are more familiar with the tools, so that we can be at ease when using all Wikimedia tools. The contacts are here for those who really want to check out our website, our Facebook page. And that's all. Thank you.
Any questions, suggestions, comments, remarks on the presentations?
Yeah, my question is, have you seen a movement in number of editors from your country related to your activities?
Yes. Concerning, for example, the OpenStreetMap, the OpenStreetMap community, we have been doing a lot of activities. Maybe I don't have the precise numbers, but ever since the beginning of the activity, the sensitizing, we have more contributions, more people contributing. Another example is concerning the Wikipedia editors. When we started, we all the members were there, but the evidence is the training sessions, we have like 15 new members actively contributing.
Training sessions. Okay. From what kind of background to what kind of contacts?
The first main criteria is to be interested. To be interested, but apart from this, there is not restrictions in terms of knowledge, but to be able to use the computer is obvious. And after this, not all of them are really at ease. Most of the time with computer, but during training sessions, no matter what background you have, you get them involved, you get them familiar with the tools. So those who, for example, those who trained during the training sessions, some of them had never been using or editing any content on the internet. They were only users, but we train them and now they can contribute them. Upload photos on the commons.
Enoch from Ghana. Yeah. How does the OpenStreetMap chapter actually works?
Okay. We have what we call counterparty. Counterparty is like we set up a plan, we decide a place to go and map. And start an event, we said one day this day we go, we start to map the area, and it's like 2 events at the same time. At the same time, it's a meeting, sometimes we also eat and share food, but and after this, we go inside to start to map the room.
One more question. the people whom you get involved into editing, from where do they edit? Do they have own access to internet, or do they go through internet cafes? Or what kind of people do you get?
Okay, normally it depends. Most of the time, it's during our usual meeting that we maximize and we contribute more. But apart from this, normally, Supercafe, just like you said, they contribute more wherever they are. We define a general plan of actions, and no matter where you are, you can contribute. But generally, it's during our meeting, and then apart from that, when they are home, they go to Supercafe.
Okay, I'm going to take one question, and then after that we're going to move on to Nigeria.
Within the various workshop or training session that you organized, did you set up a specific topic for people to contribute upon, or did you just let them in front of their laptop and trying to write something about what they are interested in?
At the very start, we did not find a precise topic, because we just wanted them to know what Wikimedia tools are. But after that, when they started to get more familiar, we defined a more precise strategy. Like this month, we write about this content, for example, about our Iowa musicians. And the other month, we write about culture. And now we did even divide into at the same month the different topics. Last month I know that we had like three different topics. Some wrote about very famous photograph. Some wrote about food. So different topics now. At the beginning not, but now we have different topics.
Okay, due to time, we're gonna allow this gentleman to go and sit down, and we're gonna give them a we'll be calling the Nigerian presenters Olorundoba, Oyolele, and Kayode Yusuf. Please rectify me or tell me how you pronounce your names first before you do the presentations, because I'm